When using Excel, you will almost always need to format your cells to display your worksheet in a professional and clean manner. We've already covered borders and fills, but to successfully create a professional-looking worksheet, you will also need to align your content, merge cells for your titles, categories, or any other data, and format your numbers correctly. Instead of trying to explain this, we will just walk you through a styling example of a simple sales forecast we threw together. Here, we've created a simple, professional-looking sales forecast complete with borders, fills, text alignment, and merged cells. Here you can see that we have the same sales forecast, except we've cleared all of the formatting. Text alignment and merging cells. Pay attention to the steps we performed to format this Excel worksheet, and you will have a decent understanding of how to use the alignment and merge commands in Excel. Step 1. We're going to activate the cells ranging from J6 to N7. Now, while holding down the control button, we select cells J8 through K9, then cells L8 and L9, and finally cells M8 through N9. Step 2. Now we locate the merge button in the ribbon and select the merge and center command. Now our sections of the worksheet are merged and the content is centered. Step 3. Now we will activate the merged cell L8, which contains the section title growth rate. Then we click on the wrap command so that the content fit properly in the cell. Step 4. Now we will place our cursor on the line between column letter J and K and double click so that cell J15 will adapt to fit the content total revenues. We will do the same for cell M15. Step 5. Now to finish up on the content alignment, we will use the middle align button for the title and section titles. While holding control, we activate all the titles and section titles and then click the middle align command. Formatting numbers. Now we are going to format the numbers in Excel. If you are working with any kind of currency, then this will be especially useful. Step 1. First we activate cells K10 through K15, and then while holding control, we activate cells N10 through N15, and then from the number format command, we select currency. Now our numbers are stated in American dollars. Step 2. Now we are going to change the currency to the British pound. We activate cells K10 through K15, and then while holding control, we activate cells N10 through N15, and then from the number format command, we select more number formats, which is at the very bottom of the list. The format cells tab dialog box will appear. We make sure that the number tab is selected. Then we locate the symbol, scroll bar, and select the British pound from the list. Adding borders. We have already covered borders in more detail in a previous tutorial, but just in case, we will show you how to do it again. Step 1. First, we activate the entire forecast and then select all borders from the borders command. Step 2. Next, we activate the entire sales forecast again, and this time select thick box border from the borders command. Adding fill color to cells. Again, we have already covered fills in previous tutorials, but we will provide a simple demonstration here. To fill colors into cells, we select the cell we want to color, and then from the fill color command, we select the color of our preference. We will then repeat this process for all cells that we want to fill with color.